Good afternoon. Welcome to Castle Coombe, home of Sunday's Chile Bucks Duathlon. Right, guys, quick race briefing for you. So this is everything you need to know. Firstly, when you arrive, you're going to come through the main competitor's entrance, and park is directed by the parking attendant in the paddock. Loads of parking, but please make sure you park well spread out to allow for social distancing. One member of your team, of your university, needs to be nominated to collect the race packs for each person. They are going to come round to this area. You can see the DB Max gazebo and collect timing chips, race numbers and race bibs. These will all actually be in an envelope with the person's name on the front. When you are collecting your chips, please make sure that you are wearing a face covering and that you maintain social distancing at all times. You can arrange then to meet the other guys in your university team and hand out the packs. Please make sure that the correct pack goes to the correct person, i.e. the person whose pack it is opens the envelope. Chip goes straight on their left ankle, race numbers on the bike and race bib on. Obviously race belts are allowed. Once handed out, anyone who's racing can come over to transition. When you come to transition, you must have a face covering on. That is compulsory. To come into transition, you are going to come through this green gate here, and this will be open, and then you will go through the green gate on the other side also into pit lane. There will be a specific section of racking for Bucks athletes. It won't be numbered. You can rack anywhere you like on that rack, but please make sure you rack in a socially distanced manner, maximum 5 people per rack. When racked, please exit in a similar way you came in. There will be an exit out and round. Go behind the back of this, the Strawford Centre, and you will go to the start. Just make sure you're at the start 5 or 6 minutes beforehand. Please, again, keep socially distanced. You must have your face covering on at this point, and you will then be called forward by the race starter. The start will be in line with this gravel area. You'll come up to your mark, and then you will go as directed. Your time starts when you cross the timing mat and you head off down into the distance, and where those pieces of Harris fencing are, they'll be removed and you'll head up to do one perimeter lap of the track. So one perimeter lap, it will be signed, and you will come and finish your lap on the far side of the circuit behind the tower. You wiggle through a Marshall's hut area and then come down the pit lane into run in. You know the rules in transition, guys. Please do not touch your bike until your helmet is on and securely fastened. You will then run with your bike to the mount point, which will be down the bottom of the pit lane. You can see an orange cone. It'll be just past that. And it's out onto the bike for 5 laps of the track, okay? Do note that transition is neutralized when you are racing. So you can keep well spread out from other competitors. So it is neutralized when you're racing. We are going to give you the Bucks athletes. We've been thinking about this for a while. Rather than the race information pack saying 5 minutes, we are giving you a maximum of 2 minutes. Okay, so 2 minutes in transition. So you can't just hang around. Once you go over 2 minutes, your time will be added. Okay, so you're out onto the track, 5 laps of the bike. For you guys as Bucks athletes, there are only 150, 160 of you. 10 metres drafting zone, please, guys. So you must be 10 metres behind someone at all times. When you're passing them, you must be 2 metres wide. This means, as well as following the drafting rules, we stick to all the social distancing rules as well. When you finish your bike, you will be coming down the pit straight and you will take a hard left to come back up the pit lane. Come up the pit lane, get to dismount roughly where the cone is there. There will be marshals here. Off your bike into transition, rack your bike where it was. Once you've racked it, you can take your helmet or unclip your helmet and take it off. And then run out, will be through this gate here. This Harris fencing will be removed and you'll run up and over the mound to start your second perimeter lap. Again, when you finish at the end of your second lap, you will wiggle onto the track at the top of the pit lane. But then instead of actually coming down the pit lane, as some of you may have done in the past with us here, you're actually going to go onto the track, follow the left-hand side of the track, the right as we're looking, and you're going to come round this final corner and finish on the track more or less opposite where we are now. When you've finished, you've got a chance to recover, but then you can take your chip off, pop it in the bin provided, clean your hands with any hand sanitizer, collect your medal, collect your beer, collect your water. You'll then come through the gap in the fence in there and head straight back into transition. We do ask that you collect your bike quickly, grab your belongings, and you will come back out of the gate here. Once you finish your race and you're back in transition, you must pop your mask back on. You can come out, exit through the gate, and you are back into the car park. Right, that's it, guys. Really excited to see you on Sunday. Going to be a great race. Fingers crossed for decent weather. Thank you very much.